examine.
Good morning, how are you? I'm going to ask you to say your name, and I'm going to ask you to keep your voice up. I have a problem keeping my voice too low, and I know you do too. So as much as you can, and as close as you can get to the microphone, that helps so that you don't necessarily have to speak loudly. It will amplify your voice, okay? So go ahead and tell us your name, please.
Donald Stone.
Okay. And Donald, how old are you?
50.
Okay. Are you married?
Yes.
And do you and your wife live together?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have children?
I have 4 children from another lady.
Okay. Do you have grandchildren?
Yes.
Okay. Are you currently working?
No.
Okay. Did you previously work?
Yes.
Okay, and what kinds of things did you do?
I did heating and cooling for Mark Blakeman.
Heating and cooling for whom?
Mark Blakeman.
Okay. And how long did you do that for?
12 years.
Okay. And was that the last job that you had?
Yeah.
Okay. And before we go any further, you have gloves on your hands.
Yes.
Is there a reason for that?
Yeah, I have a skin condition.
Okay, all right. Mr. Stone, can you tell us, without giving us the address, where approximately do you live?
I live at Piketon.
Okay. And can you tell me, do you know Kenneth Roden?
Yes, I do.
And how do you know Kenneth Roden?
He's my cousin.
Okay. And how are you related? I mean, which one of, is it your mother or father or?
His mother and my father was brother and sisters.
His mother and your father?
Yes.
Are siblings. Okay. Some cousins are close, some aren't. Would you consider yourself to have been close to Kenneth?
Real close.
Okay, and tell us about that.
Just, you know, any time that I was down and out, the man was there to help me.
Okay. How long would you say that you had a close relationship with him? Like from childhood or later in life or?
From childhood.
And how often would you say you saw each other growing up?
It's just, you know, here and there, you know.
Was there ever a time where you guys lived on the same road also?
It's actually, we didn't live on the same road. We just, you know, we were close at one time.
Okay. Did you ever, you lived physically close to him?
Yes.
Okay. And where was that?
I lived on Meadow Run and he lived on Miller's Lane.
Okay. He lived on Miller's Lane and you lived where?
On Meadow Run.
Okay. And those are close to one another?
Yes.
Okay. And do you recall approximately how long that was for?
I'd say a good 10 years.
And was he married at the time?
Yes.
Okay. And do you know who he was married to?
Stacy Rigsby.
Okay. And did they have children?
Yes.
And do you know the names of those children?
Yes.
And what is that?
Tajana, Luke, and Kendra.
Okay. And at some point, did Kenneth move away from that location?
Yes.
Okay. And do you know why he moved away?
No.
Okay. Did his wife and children remain at that location, do you know?
Yes.
Okay. And can you tell us what kinds of things would you and Kenneth do together?
It just, like if he needed something worked on or whatever, we did that together. Cars.
Would you guys go to auctions together?
Yes.
Buy cars?
Yeah.
And then work on them?
Yeah.
Okay. Fix them up and sell them, or?
Yeah.
Okay. And did you know that he was living out on Left Fork Road?
Not at the time, no.
Had you ever been out to his house before?
One time.
One time?
Yes.
Okay. And do you recall what that was for?
I was working on one of his cars.
Okay. Did you go inside the residence at that time?
No.
Okay. Do you recall in relation to the day that you, that these events happened, do you recall how long prior to that had you been at his house?
It was it was probably, I don't know, a few weeks or so.
Okay.
Before we went to the auction.
Okay. So you had gone to an auction?
Yes.
Okay. A few weeks prior?
Yes.
Okay. And did you buy anything at the auction that time?
No.
Did he buy anything?
He bought the...
Bought the vehicle?
Yes.
And that's the one that you went over to work on?
No, I worked on a car before the auction.
Okay, all right. Okay, so I'm mixing this up. You previously went over there to work on a car that had nothing to do with the car that Kenneth bought at the auction a few weeks
no,
prior.
No.
Okay. That's just the last time that you saw him was at the auction.
Yes.
Okay. Do you have any recollection of what kind of car he bought at the auction that day?
No, I don't remember.
Okay. Can you tell us, Mr. Stone, at the time, back in April of 2016, were you still working at that time for the heating and cooling company?
Mm-hmm. I believe I was.
Okay. And can you tell us how did you learn that something had happened up on Union Hill Road?
Well, I was at a HUD appointment that morning, and I had talked to a gentleman while I was there, and he asked me if I heard what happened on Union Hill. And then after my HUD appointment, I went back home, and that's when I tried making phone calls.
So you were at a HUD appointment, is that what you said?
Yes.
Okay, and somebody asked you, somebody that worked there or another person?
Yes.
Somebody that worked there, okay. And you said then once you were back home, you made some phone calls. Who
yes.
did you call? Do you recall?
Well, I tried to call Kenneth's phone.
Okay.
And then I tried to call Luke's phone, no answer. Luke Roden. And then once I got word that there was some people meeting at a church, we had went to the church.
Okay. And where was the church?
Union Hill.
Okay. Just kind of across 32 from where
yeah.
the family lived?
Yes.
And did you know Chris Roden as well?
Yes.
Okay. And all of the rest of the siblings?
Yes.
You knew them as well? You were just closer to Kenneth because of living near him and such?
Yes.
Okay. Had you ever been up to Chris Roden's residence on Union Hill Road?
Just one time. I had to work on a truck for Kenneth.
Okay. And tell me about that. Was Kenneth living there at that time?
No, he was living. He wasn't living on Union Hill, no.
Okay. But he had a truck up there?
Yes.
That he wanted you to work on?
Yes.
Okay. And when you worked on that, where on the property did you work on it?
It was at Chris Senior's. Yes.
Okay. Did you know Frankie and Hannah Mae and little Chris as well?
Yes.
Okay. So you went to the church on Union Hill Road, and who all was there?
It's just, there was a lot of people there, family. I mean, there was a lot of people there.
Okay. If you had to guess approximately how many?
150 people.
150? Okay. And I imagine there was a lot of information, a lot of talking going on.
Yes.
Okay. And a lot of consulting. At what point did you learn how many had been killed on Union Hill Road?
Actually, I hadn't known at the time how many there were for sure.
Okay. Some mixed information?
Yes.
Okay. Was there a point, you indicated that you tried to call Kenneth that one time, and that was from your home after the HUD appointment?
Yes.
Okay. Did you personally ever try to call Kenneth after that?
Yes. Okay. Well, when I tried to make the phone calls, I did try to call him once.
Okay. And while you were at the church, did there become some concerns about Kenneth not responding to phone calls?
Yeah.
Okay. And can you tell us, did you decide to go to Kenneth's at some point?
Yeah, we was at the church, and Luke mentioned that he wanted to go to his dad's place, and he asked me if I wanted to go, and we went.
Okay. Were you aware as to whether he also had tried to call his father?
No, I wasn't aware.
Okay. And so you and Luke went. Did anybody else go with
you? Yes.
Who else went?
Sean Watson.
Okay. And who's Sean?
Sean is my cousin also.
Do you remember what vehicle you took or who drove?
We took my stepdaughter's car.
Okay.
And Sean Watson drove.
Okay. Do you know where Kenneth was working at the time?
He was working in Columbus.
Okay. Do you know how long he had been working there?
No.
And you got to, did you go to Kenneth's and what did you do once you got there?
We got there, we got out of the car, we walked up to the door, me and Luke, and once we got to the door, I told him, I said, this is your dad's place, you need to go in first. And he went in first, and I followed him.
Okay. And can you tell us, first of all, where was Sean at this time?
Sean was down by the car.
Okay. So he did not walk up to the property with you or enter the residence. Where did you guys park?
We parked behind the truck, Kenny's truck.
Okay. And you know Kenny's truck?
Yes.
Okay. When you walked up to the residence, did you notice, was the door unlocked?
Yes.
So you walked into the residence together, and you said Luke was there first, but then you, and then what happened?
And then we walked in. We walked into the, supposedly the living room, and I noticed to the right, I didn't see him in there nowhere, so I seen a stairway to the right, and I walked up the stairway, and that's where I found him up there in his bed.
And when you say you found him, who did you find?
I found Kenny.
Can you tell us what condition you found him in?
He had blood all over his eyes.
And where was he located?
In his bed.
Okay. Did you believe him to be dead or alive at that time?
He was dead.
Was it just you that walked up those stairs and saw Kenneth?
Yes.
Okay. When you saw him, first of all, did you touch him at all?
No.
Okay, so you did not touch the bed at all or move anything?
No.
Okay. What did you do then?
We went straight back out the door.
Okay. And then what did you do?
When we was out on the porch, Luke asked me if I could help him get some of his some things, and then we walked out to the building. He wanted us to walk out to the building. He thought maybe somebody might have been in the building.
Okay. And where was the building located?
Located outside the camper, beside the camper.
Okay. And did you ever enter that building yourself?
Just opened the door.
Okay. And was there anybody in there?
No.
Okay. And did you see anything in there in the building itself?
Just marijuana.
Okay. So there was marijuana in that building?
Yes.
Okay. Did you touch or move anything in that building?
No.
Okay. And prior to that moment, did you know that there was marijuana in that building?
No.
Okay. Then what did you do?
After I left the building, we went out and to the end of the driveway, and I tried to call 911. I couldn't, so I had to drive up the road to call 911.
Okay. So was it you personally trying to call 911?
Yes.
Okay. And you said you couldn't. Why couldn't you?
Every time I would try, it would default my call. It would kick my call off.
Okay. So you weren't getting good cell phone service?
No.
Okay. And so you said you went up the road. Were you walking at this point or driving?
We drove.
You drove. Okay. And when you exited when you first went to the end of the driveway, were you driving at that point? Like you'd gotten back in the vehicle?
We got back in the vehicle and backed out of the driveway.
Okay. All right. And how far up the road did you have to go before you could make a call?
A good 1,000, 1,500 feet.
Okay. And then was it you again that made the phone call?
Yes.
911?
Yes.
Okay. And what did you tell them?
I called them and told them that I'd found Kenneth Roden dead in his home.
Okay. All right. And then, did you stay there and wait for them to come?
Yes.
Were you there when the police arrived?
Yes.
Did you ever go back into that location?
No.
Into his house?
No.
Or any of the structures on
the
property?
No.
Mr. Stone, I'm going to have them play the 911 call that you made that day. I just want you to listen to it, and then afterwards I'll ask you if you recognize it, okay?
Yeah, for the record, I'm going to play this external hard drive. It's got a zip sticker on it. Outside the exhibit sticker says video and audio on it. Inside the hard drive, there are folders. There's a folder marked O, 911 calls. This will be state exhibit O2.
Yep. 911 call. Conversation recorded on April 22nd, 2016 at 13:26 on channel 1.
Yeah, I need a deputy who's been out to close to 799 West 4th.
Okay.
All this stuff is on the news. I just found my cousin with a gunshot wound.
Okay. Sir, is he alive?
No.
Okay. We're at 799 West 4th?
It's close to 799. I don't know what his address is. He don't have a box.
He don't have a box. Okay.
I'll be standing out by the railway corner.
What's your name, sir?
Donald Stone.
Donald Stone?
Donald Stone.
Stone?
I'm in Seven.
What's his name?
Kenneth Roden.
Kenneth Roden?
Yeah.
Okay, sir, are you out of the house?
I'm out of the house right now. I just went in, hollering at him, and checked the door right now. And I looked up at him, he had a gunshot wound.
Okay, sir, we're going to get deputies out there to you, okay? All right.
Thank you. Bye.
End of recording.
Do you recognize that phone call?
Yes.
Okay. And is that the 911 call that you made that afternoon on April 22nd of 2016?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Stone, you indicated on the 911 call that you believed it was a gunshot wound. What made you say that?
It's just, there's extremely a lot of blood all over his face.
And you indicated on the 911 call that you hollered at Kenneth when you entered the residence? Okay.
Yes.
While you were waiting, was there an individual that arrived on a four-wheeler looking for things in trees?
Yes.
Okay. Did you know that person?
Yes.
Okay, and what was his name?
Brett Hatfield.
Okay. And at the time, did you know what he was looking for?
No, I did not.
Okay. And what did you tell him?
I told him that if he's planning on taking anything from there, to not be doing it because I called 911.
And you said you stayed there until the police arrived, correct?
Yes.
And once the police arrived, what happened?
And once the police arrived, then they turned around and told me to come with them and put me in the cruiser and handcuffed me.
They handcuffed you?
Yes.
And put you in the cruiser? Okay. And did they ultimately take you down to the police station to be interviewed?
Yes.
Okay. And did they take anybody else to be interviewed?
And they took Luke.
Okay. Did they ever take your fingerprints or DNA or anything from you?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay. And did they take any of your clothing or anything else?
No.
Okay. And you indicated you did not touch anything in there.
No.
Is that correct? Donald, when Kenneth Roden lived on Miller's Lane, did you ever know him to grow marijuana?
Yes.
Okay, and where did he grow marijuana at that location?
Back in the field.
Back in the field? Okay. Did you ever know him to have an indoor grow at
No.
that location?
No.
Mr. Stone, I'm going to put up a series of photographs. I'm going to start with just the outside of the camper and stuff. It's going to be displayed on the screen above your head, but it's also going to be displayed right there. So you can look at the pictures that are close to you.
Okay.
States Exhibit D1, which is 1872. Do you recognize that location?
Yes.
And what do you recognize that as?
Kenneth Roden's place.
Okay. 1888, which is States Exhibit D17. And is that Kenneth's place again?
Yes.
Okay. And do you recognize any of the vehicles in that location?
Yes.
And what do you recognize them as?
All three of those are Kenny's trucks.
Okay. And when you pulled into that location, then you would have been just behind those vehicles?
Yes.
Initially?
Yes.
Okay. And then 1896, which is States Exhibit D25. Again, that's just a closer up view there, but is that one of Kenneth's trucks?
Yes.
Okay. And in the background there, is that the residence that you entered?
Yes.
Another camper off to the left there of the residence. Was that also on Kenneth's property?
Yes.
D50, which is 1921. And what all do you see in that photo?
I see the building.
And is that the building that had the marijuana in it?
Yes.
Okay. And D86, which is 957. Again, is that the building that had the marijuana in it?
Yes.
Okay. Did you notice any cameras at that location?
No, I did not.
Okay. D89, 1960. Does that appear to be a camera on that building?
Yes.
Okay. You did not notice that at the time?
No.
Okay. And then D90. Which is 1961. You can probably see it better than the jurors can, but does there appear to be a camera there to the left
yes.
of the door?
Yes.
Okay. And again, you did not notice that
no.
that day.
No.
Okay. And do you recognize that?
Yes.
And what do you recognize that as?
Kenny's place.
Okay. I should D133, which is 2004. Mr. Stone, there appears to be a lock on the porch there. Do you recall seeing that at all at the time?
Yes.
Okay. And was that how it was when you first arrived there?
Yes.
Okay. D138, which is 2010. Do you recognize that?
Yes.
And what is that?
That's inside the home.
Okay, and that's when you first walk in there,
yeah.
that front door. D139. 2011. And again, is that the area when you first walk in?
Yes.
Okay. D163, which is 2035. It's so hard to see that. Do you recognize that?
Yes.
And what do you recognize that as?
That's Candy's bed.
And do you remember when you walked into that room, which side of the bed would you have been on?
At the foot of it.
Okay. Showing you what's been marked as D 180 2052 and should not publish. Do you recognize that photo?
Yes.
And can you tell us what you recognize that as?
It's for Kaylee Swift.
Okay. And is that how you saw Kenneth lying in his bed when you entered that residence?
Yes.
Mr. Stone, can you look at that? I'm sorry. What do you recognize that as?
Kidney.
And is that how you saw him on that day?
Yes.
And you indicated that he had, does that match your recollection of the blood that you saw him?
Yes.
Okay. Did you get any closer than the foot of the bed?
No.
Okay. The items that were there, D-185, I'm going to show the picture of the foot of the bed. There appears to be money, coins, keys, and a pair of pants there. Again, is that as you found it that day?
Yes.
Okay, and you did not touch any of those items?
No.
Okay. Put that down. And Mr. Stone, you exited that residence basically as soon as you saw?
Yes.
And Luke exited along with you?
Yes.
Okay. This is D as in dog, 286. Do you recognize this location? Okay, and what is this location?
That's Katie's residence.
Okay. And again, there are his vehicles. Can you tell us approximately where you would have been parked when you first got there?
By the truck.
Okay. behind the middle truck?
Yes.
So like in this area here?
Yes.
Okay. And then once you went to the end of the driveway to call, you said then you went, do you remember which direction you went?
Back here and went out the driveway.
Okay. So you backed there and then went out the driveway here? Okay. And then when you were waiting for the police, where did you, where were you?
The driveway.
At the end?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Come back there, sorry. So again, if you can show them where you were parked when you first got there. And then when you exited, which direction did you go?
Here.
And then where did you wait for the police?
The driveway.
Mr. Stone? Was there a dog at Kenneth's house?
Yes.
And did you know the dog's name?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. And was the dog normally inside or outside when you had been there prior? Do you recall?
When I was there prior?
Yeah.
He was outside.
Okay. And what about on this day?
He's inside.
And so when you entered the residence, he was inside?
Yes.
Okay. And do you remember where?
Right by the door.
Right by the door?
Okay. Yes.
Had he barked at all or anything?
Nothing.
Okay. And did he go outside then?
Yes.
The residence? Okay. And did you ever know the Wagners?
No.
And would you describe the Rodens as a close-knit family?
Yes.
Okay. And what makes you say that?
It's just, you know, their mother fed me when I was young, and they're just helpful people.
Okay.
You'd help anyone.
And did they also look out for one another?
Yes, they did.
And would you say that they would protect each other?
Yes.
If something happened to one of them?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Okay. I have another question, Your Honor.
The defense may cross-examine.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Mr. Stone, I understand these are some tough questions. Do you need a minute to collect yourself, or are you okay to go forward?
I'm good.
I want to go over the answers that you had just given the prosecutor. I just need some more detail on that, okay? And when I ask you questions, I'll need you to answer out loud, all right?
Okay.
All right, thank you. My understanding is you were at the church on Union Hill Road and you left there to go to Kenneth's, is that right?
Yes.
And who went with you?
Luke and Sean Watson.
And Sean Watson?
Yes.
And you guys all rode in one vehicle?
Yes.
What kind of vehicle is that?
It's a little yellow car. I don't know what the name of it was.
A car?
Yes.
Okay, all right. And so there's an exhibit here that you were shown a picture, and I'm going to show you what's been previously marked as State's Exhibit D-286. Your Honor, may I approach?
Yes.
Thank you. And so, if I hold this here, can all of the jurors and this? Thank you. All right, Mr. Stone, do you recognize this exhibit that I have, or that has been marked as D-286?
Yes.
And what is this?
It's Kenneth's residence.
Okay. Are you able to point to actually where he lived? Because I see three different structures there. All right, so you're pointing to the middle one. And you would agree with me that this is a driveway going up to that, to his camper, right?
Yes.
And when you guys drove there in that car, can you tell me where you parked? And you can point at that
behind the,
if you need to.
Behind the black truck.
Okay, so I see, do you mind to get up and point for me? Okay, so you can go ahead and sit down. I'm gonna point where you did, because I think you may have blocked some jurors. So right here, see where I'm pointing?
Yes.
That's a truck, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, and you parked behind that truck?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me how far is the distance from where you parked, or where the vehicle in which you rode in, where it parked, and the front door of that camper?
I have no idea.
Okay. You couldn't even approximate in feet? But nevertheless, that car was parked here, and you would agree with me that the front door to that camper would be right there. Is that
yep.
right?
Approximately 100 feet.
About 100 foot. Okay. All right. Thank you. Now, you were questioned by some BCI agents about this. Is this right?
Yes.
In fact, you went down to the Pike County Sheriff's Department to answer those questions.
Yes.
And at some point in that questioning, you were asked whether or not you had taken anything from Ken's residence.
Yes.
And you didn't, right?
Right.
And you told them you didn't need to because Ken was well off, is that right?
Yes.
And he would give you money anytime you needed it.
Yes.
All right. And I also, during that questioning, on the day of your discovery of Ken, you were questioned about the marijuana, is that right?
Yes.
And you had told that the BCI agent that you knew of Ken to traffic in marijuana, is that right?
Yes.
All right. Now, in regard to that camper again, how many people went to that front door of that camper?
Just me and Luke Roden.
Okay. And so tell me again, who was first to enter?
Luke.
All right. And you followed in behind him, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, and so both of you were there inside that camper?
Yes.
And you just stayed at the foot of the bed, is that right?
Yes.
All right. Just hold on one moment for me.